Thank you very much, Mr. Sumar Dinora, the head of the Indonesian Center for Agricultural Training Center. Now we are heading to the main critical activities of our today's live session. First of all, I would like to give you some technical information about how to address your questions or feedback. You can address your questions or feedback in writing by using the Q&A feature. You can see the icon in the bottom of your screen, or you can address your question or feedback verbally by using the raise hand feature, and I will open the access for microphone for you. So right now we are heading to the presentation and Q&A from Mrs. Lutfi Tri Ambriani. Mrs. Lutfi, maybe you can start sharing your screen while I'm reading out on your brief profile. So Mrs. Lutfi Tri Ambriani has 11 years of experience providing training on sustainable agriculture, plant disease, plant pathology, integrated pest and disease management, and agroecosystem. She holds a master's degree in plant sciences. She's now teaching at the Indonesian Center for Agricultural Training of Kingdom, Ministry of Agriculture, Republic of Indonesia. She published scientific journals and books on ecological control of plant pest organisms and usage of plant growth promoting bacteria. In this today's session, she will give presentation and simulation on ecologically based integrated pest management. Without further ado, I will give the floor to Mrs. Lutfi. Mrs. Lutfi, the floor is yours. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Good afternoon and good morning. I would like to say thank you and honor to meet you here. I hope you always stay happy, stay healthy, and stay productive during this pandemic. And I hope this pandemic will end immediately. Amin. Today, we will sharing simulation and discuss about ecologically based integrated pest management. But before I start it, we will start the video about virtual tour International Center of Agricultural Training Ketindan, especially the Plant Protection Department. I hope all of you will enjoy this training. Please, the presentation. Okay. This is the video about Virtual Tour International Center of Agricultural Training, Ketindan. Apologies me because the video is small because I have to reduce the size. So all of you, if your bandwidth is low, we can still access it. I hope all of you will enjoy this training. Okay. I'm sorry, the voice is not clear. Okay. Okay, I will start the video. It's starting from entrance. Then the piece. This is the entrance of its Center Agricultural Training Ketindan. And apologies me if I have no stability, so the movement are not smooth. Plant Protection Department, who provides training about pest and plant disease management. There are a lot of products for integrated pest management. Then we are going to botanical pesticide garden. This is the garden, the sow window for plant material to make botanical pesticide. Thank you. classroom to help the training. And from this video, I hope all of you have an overview of International Center of Agricultural Training Ketinggan. Okay, I will start this session. The topics is ecologically based integrated pest management. The learning objective are at the end of this session, the participants should have a better understanding of pest and plant diseases and the component of agroecosystem ecology as the basic of integrated pest management. And we need farm for a variety of reasons. People in the world always need a food which only can produce from farming. To fully human food requirement, human produce food by farming, turning forests into monoculture environments. The effect of monoculture was increase the population of pests and plant diseases because the food of pests is available in large scale. Plus, the climate change caused the plant disease more easily to develop. So we have to manage the pest and plant diseases by integrated pest management. From FAO definition, integrated pest management means the careful consideration of all available pest control techniques and subsequent integration of appropriate measures that discourage the development of pest population and other intervention to levels that are economically justified and reduce or minimize risk to human health and the environment. IPM emphasizes the growth of a healthy crop with the least possible disruption to agroecosystem and encourages natural pest control mechanism. In Indonesia, there are four principles for applicate the IPM. First, cultivation of healthy plants. Second, pest monitoring. Third, natural enemy conservation. And four, farmers as expert in IPM. And the base of integrated pest management is agroecosystem modification for long-term solution to the problem of pest and plant disease can only be achieved through the improvement and management of agroecosystems in a way that maximizes preemptive action, especially to prevent attack before the pest enable. Agroecosystem is communities of organisms interacting with their environment, which is modified to produce agricultural goods. And agroecosystem design is planning of the spatial and temporal arrangement of an agroecosystem, as well as its agrobiodiversity and management, considering the interaction of its components mutually and with their environment. In a simple terms, agroecosystem is designing agricultural farms as closely as possible to the condition of forest biodiversity. That's why we have to know about ecologically based integrated pest management. This picture is described of the ecologically based integrated pest management. There are a lot of components of an agroecosystem for IPM so that the pest and plant diseases expected decrease naturally. And this picture, which is the explanation of principle of IPM in Indonesia. First, cultivation of healthy plant we take in by star, like intercropping, and then flower border, and then nutrient management. And then pest monitoring, we tag it by hashtag, this is pest, and we have to know about plant disease. Third, natural enemy conservation, we tag it by plus, like refugia tool, and then natural enemy. And then mycorrhizae, PGBB, and trichoderma. And for farmer as expert in IPM, this is the farmer. The first, the principle of integrated pest management in Indonesia for cultivation of healthy plant. This is an intercropping. Intercropping is an all-encompassing term for the practice of growing two or more crops in close proximity, mixed cropping or polycultures, and plant cultivation according to standard operational procedure, for example, space between the plant, pruning of plantation crop, and etc. This is the example in Indonesia for intercropping. It's still by Indonesian, but we want to all of you know about the application for this intercropping, not only the mixed cropping or polyculture, but also the refugia. This is rice and corn, and before rice and refugia. Using intercropping to disrupt host finding by some host-specific insect pests, usually by disrupting the ability of the pest to find its host. Choosing an intercrop that does not host key pests on the main crop is critical. A mixture of leaf shapes can similarly confuse insects that search for their host by sight. For some pests, simply alternating rows or strips of different crops can be sufficient to interfere with insect movement or host finding ability. And then this is an example for crop and then in crop plant. What the pest reduce and the mechanism are predator or parasitic. And then about healthy soil, this is include for the cultivation of healthy plant, because a healthy soil and plant healthy plant is make the plant free from pest and plant disease. The first is organic matter, the second is nutrient management, third is cover crop, and four, beneficial organism in the soil. This is organic matter or organic fertilizer. The beneficial of the usage of organic matter or organic fertilizer are enhanced moisture and aeration used for, and the organic matter used for beneficial microorganism habitat. And then don't burn the straw on the rice field. Not to burn the straw, because there are a lot of micronutrients on the straw was needed by soil and plant. Better to composting the straw and apply it to the soil. Then reason to compost, the first improves plant growth, reduce soil erosion, allow soil to retain more water, enhance soil fertility, reduce waste, landfill and burn, benefit soil structure, allow soil to retain more nutrients, stores carbon in soil to protect the climate, builds community resilience and power, and something everyone can do, because compost is very simple. This is a solid waste or food waste. And then with effective microbial composter and will be the compost. The second is nutrient management. First, we have to soil test to our soil to measure nutrient and pH requirement so that the nutrient providing as the requirement. And we have to, although more research is needed to clarify that relationship between crop nutrition and pests. Most studies assessing the response of aphids and mites to nitrogen fertilizer have documented dramatic expansion in pest number with increases in fertilizer rates. So overdose of N fertilizer synthetic is increases the pest number. So we have to measure the soil nutrient. So we have to know the profit the nutrient providing as the requirements. This is the potential synergism between soil fertility management and IPM. If the fertilizer is enough, that enhance soil fertility and then synergism enhance pest regulation, healthy crop, and then healthy agro ecosystem. Then cover crop. For availability of organic nitrogen, we have to plant cover crop. Cover crop plant after harvesting until it will replanted to the new crops. For example, this is Crotalaria. To cover crop. And then the fourth for healthy soil, focus on beneficial microorganism. Soil health is essential for good root and plant growth. Microorganisms are principal actors of soil's life, and so they play a prominent role in plant development. Many microorganisms, such as bacteria, fungi, especially mycorrhizal fungi, are acting on the plant also as biostimulant. This is the example fungi in the picture described of the ecologically based integrated pest management before. I have explained that there is a beneficial microorganism, for example, mycorrhizae, PGBB, plant growth promoting bacteria, and then Trichoderma as the fungi. So it's similar with the picture that I described. The advantage are for the fungi, degradation of organic matter, and then solubilization of nutritional elements, root biostimulation, formation of aggregates, root colonization, and competition with other organisms. So in Trichoderma, usually, it is competitor for pathogen. And then bacteria, for example, plant growth promoting bacteria. And we will explain it after this. And then mycorrhizae is the name of the plant fungus symbiosis. Without the root, the fungus dies. Increase of root absorption area, carrier of nutritional elements and water, increase water retention capacity, improvement of tolerance to abiotic stress, and then biostimulation of roots and formation of aggregates or better soil structure. And how to increase microorganism development? We need water, temperature, oxygen, organic matter, nutritional elements, and pH that available for the microorganism development. And this is plant growth promoting bacteria. And the member are rhizospheric, rhizospheric bacteria beans to root or seed surface, and then endophytic, typically in tissues inside the plant, and then symbiotic, typically in root nodules, and then cyanobacteria may not bind to plant fixed spot N and C. So plant growth promoting bacteria has a lot of member. The beneficial of plant growth promoting bacteria are the first biostimulant, enhanced plant growth cause the ability to produce growth regulator hormone indole acetic acid, and then bioprotectant, increase plant resistance cause the ability to produce antibiotic, and then biofertilizer solubilizing phosphate. So that easy to absorb by plant. This is mass production of or propagation of PGBB, plant growth promoting bacteria, and we will simulation it after this presentation. This is the material, like bran, sugar, fish paste, bamboo root, and calcium. And then equipment, only burner, and then pan and filter. And then we can propagation of plant growth promoting bacteria by pure isolato. So this is two methods. The first is bamboo root, and the second is by pure isolate. By liquid media, by pure isolate, we need potatoes, and then we have to peel it, and then slice it to be smaller, and then boil it, filter it. Only we need the water, the extract. And then add the sugar, and it will be potato extract. After this, we have to sterilize it with autoclave on 20 minutes or with steamer in 2 hours. And then cool it down, and adding pure isolate aseptically. After that, we have to running to the simple bioreactor. This is the simple bioreactor. We need aerator, and then gallon, and then potassium permanganate, then glass wool or filter, and then media plus isolate, and then boil water control. And we will simulate it after this presentation. Okay, we continue to the ecologically based integrated pest management, as I described the picture before. And the principle of the IPM in Indonesia. Number two is pest monitoring. If we are going to pest monitoring, of course, we have to know the differences between pests and plant diseases. Pests are animals whose life activities, feeding, sheltering, and reproducing, interfere crop production. To be able to carry out pest management appropriately, the identification of the pest must be correct. And then the factors that make animals become pests. The first is population resurgence. The effect of most chemical pesticide is short life nowadays. And once the suppressive effect declines, the pest population will naturally resurge, possibly up to the economic injury level again. There may also be resurgence of a secondary pest due to insecticidal destruction of natural enemies, or from some other ecological upset. Oh, I'm sorry, this is number two, right, for the picture. And number one is monoculture. The forest become a monoculture environment. So monoculture is the one of the factors that make animals become pests. The growing of single crop species over a large area provides an unlimited source of food for pest species, especially when the crop plant is particularly succulent and offer of and fertilizer synthetic. The present worldwide tendency is towards mechanized agriculture, which requires larger fields and fewer hedgerows, which traditionally delimited each field. And so that crop monoculture become even more extensive. This practice will encourage some insect species to become more abundant and hence important as pests in the field. And then number three, it's migration. In the picture is the example of migration of Locusta migratoria. So some insect migration to the some field and then only for a while, but it can make damage in this field. So it be the factor that make animal become pests. And then number four, this is a human perspective. Sometimes pests in one area are not pests in other areas based on human perspective. For example, the rodent in Java, Indonesia is a real pest which is can damage the farm and make losses. But in Manado, Indonesia too, it's not a pest. It's consumed by human. Like that. Human perspective is one of the factors that make animal become pests. And then number five is continuous cropping. The plantation and orchard crops are all very long term, and because of this, they suffer from particular pest problem. But in compensation, their pests are to some extent controlled by natural enemies. Field crops are typically characterized by their short duration, as at most they are annuals, and sometimes by careful timing, the crop may be grown before the pest population catch up. And there are the factors that make animals become pests. The first is monoculture. The second is pesticide application and make population resurgence. And then number three is migration. Number four is human perspective. And then number five is continuous cropping. And then insect pest characteristic. To classify insect become pest is determined by the mouthparts. The first thing sucking a big trough which liquid food is ingested, example Hemipteran, Homoptera, and thrips. And the second, biting or mandible egg as jaws, example grasshoppers, beetles, termites, and larval moths. And the example for the pest like this. Biting insect may damage plant as follows. Reduce the amount of leaf assimilative tissue and hinder plant growth. Examples are leaf eaters such as adults and nymphs of locust and epilahna and larva of plutella. And then the picture, this is the A picture, is this example of larva of plutella on the catfish. And then B, tunnel in the stem and interrupt sap flow, often destroying the apical parts of the plant. These are stem borers and shoot flies, such as Zeuxera in apple plants, Cepus in wheat, Ostrinia in mice, Atherigona in mice and sorghum. And the example B is Ostrinia furnacalis in mice. And let's see ring bark stems, for example, some Cerambycidae. This is the example, is C. And then D, destroy buds or growing points and cause subsequent distortion or proliferation. For example, fruit bud weevils. The D is example. And then cause premature fruit fall as with cherry fruit fly, codling moth and apple soft fly. This is the example for E. And then attack flowers and reduce seed production as with the blossom beetles and Japanese beetle. This is the example of Japanese beetle. And then G, injure or destroy seeds completely or reduce germination due to loss of food reserves. Example, hazelnut weevil, maize weevil, pea and bean crookit, pea pod borers, and bean pod borers. This is the example is G. And then attack rots and cause loss of water and nutrient absorbing tissue, as with wireworms and various caper of larvae and other beetle larvae in the soil. The H is the example. And then E, remove stored food from tubers and combs and affect next season growth. Example are cutworm and wireworm in potato and potato tuber moth larvae. This is the example. And then plant diseases. A plant disease is an abnormality in the structure and or function of the host plant cells and or tissue as a result of a continuous irritation caused by a pathogenic agent or an environmental factor. Plant disease can be broadly classified according to the nature of their primary causal agent, either infectious or non-infectious. Infectious plant diseases are caused by a pathogenic organism such as a fungus, bacterium, mycoplasma, virus, and nematode. And then non-infectious plant diseases are caused by unfavorable growing condition, including extreme of temperature, disadvantageous relationship with moisture and oxygen, toxic substances in the soil or atmosphere, and an excess or deficiency of an essential mineral. This is the morphology and ways of multiplication of some of the group of plant pathogen. This is fungi, bacteria, molecules, parasitic higher plants, viruses, and nematodes. And then, we continue to the principle of integrated pest management, number three. This is natural enemy conservation. This is the resume of natural enemy or biological control agent. The biological control agent is beneficial insect. The member are predator and parasitoid. And then beneficial microorganism as the agent of biological control. The member are insect pathogen and then antagonistic agent. The insect pathogen and antagonistic agent, the member are fungi, bacteria, and virus. And for predator and parasitoid, if we want to keep availability to the farm, we have to plant refugia or flower border. In Indonesia, we call refugia. Refugia is an area overgrown with several types of plants that can provide shelter, feed sources for natural enemies such as predators and parasitoids. It can be planted polyculture or intercropping with other plants. So the refugia have two advantages. The first is for predators and parasitoids, and two, it's intercropping. The criteria of refugia plants, the first, choose plants that have flowers and streaking colors, like this. And then number two, rapid and sustainable plant regeneration seeds. Our seeds are easy to obtain, easy to plant. So easy to applicate this refugia. This is the example of refugia, the flowering plants that attract natural enemies. So not only this plant, but also a lot of flower, like dill, blanket flower, yarrow, coriander, golden root, tansy, cosmos, and then sunflower, and etc. And then the mechanism of natural enemies with refugia with the pest. Natural enemies naturally will control pests, act as predators and parasitoids. Naturally, it already exists in nature, but we need to keep it sustainable and its availability in farm by planting flowering plants around the farm or as a corridor in a farm. The mechanism of parasitoid in pest control, plants are well placed to influence the efficiency of parasitism and predation, and they mediate numerous interactions between entomophages, arthropods and herbivores. Their structures and products often supply essential resources for parasitoid and predator. In addition, chemical and morphological plant attributes can affect the efficacy of biological control agent. The picture described of volatile compounds are released by plants in response to insect feeding trick by an interaction of elicitors from the oral secretion of insect herbivores with the damaged plant tissue. These volatiles are used by some parasitoid wasps to locate their host. If we plant flowering plants or refugia around the farm, natural enemies easy to find food or nectar, habitat and shelter, then when any pest in cultivated plants, it can be used by parasites to reproduce in or on the bodies of insect pests. So the pest will be controlled by parasites. And then refugia as corridor plant is used to block the spread of pests because the difference of the movement of parasitoid and movement of pest, like this picture. So we hope that with the refugia corridor or flower border, the movement of pest can be minimized. So that in the picture, crop and then refugia by the corridor. And then this is the example of parasitoid on our fields in International Center of Agricultural Training Ketindan. We plant sunflower and then the parasitoid automatically come to the flower for find the nectar, and then if it has a pest, it will be controlled by this parasitoid. This is the example. And then this is the example of refugia sunflower to the rice field, and then a refugia as the corridor to minimize the pest attack. And then we'll continue to the principle of integrated pest management in Indonesia. The fourth principle, there are the farmers as expert in IPM. We have to make a group farmer meet to manage the action plan about preemptive solution on the farm. We cannot alone, but we have to make a group farmer, because alone we can do so little and together we can do so much. So we have to make a group farmer. And this is the last of my presentation, and the last sentence of this presentation are the more variety and the better society. And we have to maintain the availability of oxygen by planting, and we have to maintain the continuity of the food chain with biodiversity. Okay, we are after this. Thank you. After this presentation, I will have a simulation of the propagation of plant growth promoting bacteria.